All right, so we've got kombucha and pickled eggs, and I saved you an uncolored pickled egg because I knew you only wanted one, and I thought you might want the red. Now you can have one or more of these too, but I saved this one out because you might not want the food that color.
No.
It's not like it's just, you know, your typical bottle of food coloring. Not special in any way. Plates for the eggs. Loves me some pickled eggs. It's a good snack. Kombucha. Woohoo! I might need to get the coconut water out of the fridge. We'll see. I've been taken to splitting this.
I say Piper apparently tends to agree. She thinks she likes pickled eggs too.
I think she wishes it was 5 o'clock already.
Time's not passing fast enough for.
Yeah, every day they push it a couple of minutes earlier. It's getting more than an hour earlier.
Oh yes, it's 3:30 and they're like, is it 5 o'clock yet? It's like me at work, I'm looking at the time. 5 o'clock yet? Nope. Okay. How about now? Nope, still not. Okay.
And clocks don't get annoyed the way people do. Yeah, I made the kombucha today with just apple juice out of the box. I need the coconut water for sure.
Coconut water for sure.
For sure. It's in the door. It's white and green.
Yep.
And funny shape. Something magnetic, no doubt.
There we go. Coconut water.
Do we know what magnetic fell and where?
It's a silver thing that fell there. It came off the shelf.
Oh, that's the counter for my weaving. It's an old, it's the kind of counter that the coach or the bus driver used to use when, in fact, it came from the bus that you use when you're counting your passengers.
Mm.
And I'm counting my weaving rolls with it. It's perfect for that.
These days, I think it's done electronically on the computer that they have that keeps their, lets them know if they're getting to their point B quick enough, too. It keeps their running time, I guess you'd call it. I don't know what they call it. Keeps time. Hell's no.
So, what would you like for pickled eggs?
I'll try this one again.
Okay. And you want just one?
Two seems good.
Okay, you'll get one of each then.
Cool.
I really like the pink. I don't care that there might be some kind of toxic something in the red because I like it so much. And I don't really think that anything that is in it is going to be that serious. I certainly notice nothing in my body that changes when I'm going between colored and not colored. By the way, the red one has red pepper in it. Yes, that's what the speckling is. There.
Oh, I see.
Red pepper.
Right, to adjust my...
Look at sunrise in Minecraft. It's a Minecraft sunrise.
Oh, I know, it's your carpet.
Oh, we missed it.
Makes it impossible, but...
Her bed, yeah. We missed it. We missed the Minecraft suns. But look at that island view, eh? So yeah, here's the thing. I'd really like to be able to have people play with me. But the only people so far who have asked for an invite are complete, total strangers watching my Mixer stream. And they come in there and they ask for an invite. And 9 times out of 10, they're just rats looking for somebody to greet. They're going to come in and they're going to smash my windows and they're going to empty my trunks. Apparently they do things like taking your best armor that you've got stored away in a trunk. You know, going into your house when you're not looking, taking out your precious things and dumping them in lava. Pure griefing. digging holes, setting create dynamite, and then set dynamite in the middle of your house and blow up your house. Because it's amusing to them. And I can see the amusement of blowing up a house. Like, I could see me going to that castle and putting in a ton of TNT just to see what happens when it blows up. Almost. I put in too many nights building it. But that is an intriguing idea, to build something for the purpose of blowing it up. See what it looks like when it's done.
Yeah, like setting up dominoes just to give
that
first one to push and
Yeah. Like that. I actually have TNT. Because when you raid a desert temple, you get TNT out of the basement. Huh. Unless you're stupid enough to trigger it and you get blown up. Which then destroys all the treasure as well. There's enough TNT to blow the temple sky high and everything in it. Huh. If you just make the mistake of dropping something on the pressure plate.
So did you buy these or make these?
Both. One evening I bought. Yeah, the Wandering Market. They make such good pickled eggs, too. That's where I got the idea. And I looked them up and I was like, hell, you know, this is a great way to preserve eggs. They're really satisfying. I think vinegar is good for you. Seems to be, I crave something with vinegar. Whether I'm putting it on a salad or I'm putting it in eggs or something, my body's asking for vinegar. I don't know why. Maybe it improves the pH balance.
Mm-hmm. Chemical balance thing was my thought on that.
Your body's got built-in sensors for that.
That's why I get cravings for things. There's times when I can walk by whatever it is, and then there's times when I can't walk by it and I have to purchase it. Need that. And I'm not just talking about chocolate, because chocolate is just a desire that I always have. Every time I walk past it, it's like, yeah, I want that. Yeah. I'm talking about vegetables and
stuff.
Well,
you need that the way you need heroin. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pure addiction, chocolate is.
It's not supposed to work that way. They're not supposed to be deliberately creating addictive drugs and marketing them as food. The reason the water is turning to ice under my boots... It's one of the metrics of this game is what they call enchantments, where you add spells to your equipment. And in this case, it's called the Frostwalker spell, the Frostwalker enchantment. The water turns to ice when I step on it.
Hmm.
It's really useful.
This way.
Oh, there's this bunny. If you look down at that spit of land, there he is. See that little bunny with the little spot on his nose?
Mm-hmm.
Looks just like some of my favorite rabbits ever. Well, he's not from here. He jumped into my boat when I was exploring one time.
Oh.
And so I let him ride home with me, and then I broke the boat out from under him. He's running away from me. He's completely wild. But I broke the boat out from under him, and he's been on my island ever since. But at this rate, the little dude just might try to swim to the other island. I'd hate that. He does kind of look like he's doing that. He's swimming for that other island because he's afraid of me. I will change his mind by walking around him on the ice. This is probably the worst kitchen chat ever. There we go. He's back on my land where I wanted him. And me, I'm going to go to the train station house. I'm going to put my... avatar on the train and let it just do its thing while we talk, because I think that's entertaining for us. I don't know about the camera. Sorry guys, this is a real lame podcast. Well, you saw how well we did with that Guantanamo Bay chat. Not so well. Oh yeah, coding. You were talking about coding. I was into coding too. I got as far as CSS2. And there's a university on the web, or was, that will teach you these things and even give you lessons. Like, real lessons with exercises and tests and things.
Huh.
And assignments. And measured lessons that are given to you via email by an instructor.
Huh.
Yep. And so,
is that for free?
It's free. Yes, it's completely free. And they're run by donation and volunteer. So, WebTechU, I think it was called.
I think I've heard of that.
Let's see if they're still around. Woohoo! Look at me go! See, this is the train ride to the abandoned mines, but I can look around. That's the back of my island. You can see how I didn't recognize it. It just looks like any old bunch of Minecraft land. But now, with all of these, there's the castle coming up. And I planted these mushrooms and then this big home sign. I mean, you can tell we're home. Then you can see the rainbow pile and the pixel art. You can see all this stuff from this side now, even that wonderful bridge. I wish I had a zoom feature, the PC version of Minecraft, as a telescoping lens feature. That would be really useful. I'm hiccuping. I don't know why. WebTechU. Let's see if WebTechU still exists. No, no, no. I wanted to go here and here. And WebTechU.org. Enter. That isn't it.
There was pop-ups happening, though, before you typed it all in. There was stuff.
Good thought.
It's in there somewhere.
.com, that's why. C-O-M.
Right.
.com? Yeah, WebTech. No. No, that's...
And you.
My name is Howard Webb. I'm a growth hacker by day and a hacker growth by night. I'm here to blog about tech, web, and self. This is not the university. Let's go to Google proper.
Hi. Mm-hmm.
Web Tech University. I've got a feeling it's dead. Well, let's find out. It is. It's gone. That's too bad. Oh, look! I'm already headed back. I must have hit the mine at the end and bounced back. Yeah? Okay. Hang on a minute. Let me go get my minecart back if I can outrun it. Yeah, it's gone. No more WebTech here. That's too bad. That was useful.
Installation guides and stuff.
I took a Microsoft Certified Professional Engineer course. MCSPE. I only made it to the A+ stage because of bullying by the other students. I was literally driven out of the class by the stress of dealing with people who made it their mission to make me unhappy there. Yes, Dan is here. I'm going to stop this recording now. Because it's toast.